Hey guys, it's your boy Michael with the H&M Reloaded channel, and we are going to be doing an updated review and test on the Noco GB150 with 3000 amps. The last video we did was a while ago, and unfortunately I forgot to add a couple things in, like the wiring and everything, and a couple other little things. I actually had it in the video, but I must have deleted it in the editing. So I apologize for that, but let's go over it again. This is the updated version of the Noco GB150, 3000 peak amp. Okay, this is my case. This does not come with the Noco GB150, just so you're aware. This is sold separately for about 40 bucks, 35, 40 bucks. Okay, let's open her up. This case has a nice handle on it. It says Noco right on the handle. It's branded Noco. Okay, and it's a really nice case. Let's open her up. Okay, and here we go. The last time I forgot to mention the wiring. Okay, here's the wiring we have. And this is the male and the female 12 volt. So this will plug into your vehicle. This will plug into your vehicle and you could charge your unit. This is the quickest way to charge it, is through the 12 volt male adapter, which is also known as the cigarette lighter adapter. Okay, let me just show you how the wiring is. Since I didn't do it the last time, I feel bad. Okay, on the Noco, it comes with two sides like this. See how it is? Okay. What you would do is you would take the one end. Ooh, here it is over here. Plug it in like that, see, for your vehicle. Now, here is your big boy, the Noco GB150. And here are the ports back here. Okay, here's the ports. See how they are? You have the micro, wait, is it micro? Yeah, you have the micro USB here, which I do not like. I wish it was a US type C. Okay, then you have your special ports over here. This is for your cigarette lighter adapter. And here's another one, you have in and out, okay? And then you have your USB here. Okay, so what you would do is, you would plug it into this port right here. Now the other half of this would go into your vehicle. And this will charge up, fully charge in 3 to 5 hours, I'm told, if you do it with this, with the cigarette lighter adapter, the 12 volt. But that's how you charge the unit. We're gonna do everything in reverse order, basically, okay? And it also comes with the female adapter, okay? See how? Now what you would do is with this one, you would put the other end in there like that, okay? Then you would unplug this one and plug this into your Noco USB on this side now, I believe. Let me double check how it's on this side now. Okay, and now this, you could power things. This is your 12 volt source. Now you plug in, you know, whatever. Camping equipment, sporting equipment, whatever. Portable vacuums, small refrigerators, okay? So that's how the wires work, okay? Just wanted to do that first so I didn't forget anything. Okay, and also your Noco GB150 comes with a big fat manual. A lot of pages. Read that up. And this case comes with these two compartments on the side here like that, see? Which is very cool. See how they open up right here like that? I like that. And it's also branded, I will show you. See how it says Noco all across here. And on this side you have the cutout. Nice material for your unit. And don't try to flip it over because the unit will fall out. It's so heavy. It's about, I think they said 6.39 pounds. So yeah, this does not come with the unit, guys. Remember, that's extra. Now here is the Noco GB150. This is a massive monster, this thing. Okay, as you can see, everything on there. Okay, I believe, let's unhook the clamps. The clamps are 4-gauge wire, guys. The Noco offers four gauge wire. I don't know if you can see it on there. Four gauge, it's on there somewhere. A nice flashlight. So you would just push and hold for a couple seconds, and this is a 500 lumen flashlight, guys. One click. Okay, now you just click it again. Less, less. Strobe, SOS. It's got, I think, six or seven different lighting on there. All white light. Okay, and there's been some controversy about this. See right up here, it says 3000 amp. Well, a while ago, a couple years back, it used to say 4000 amp on there. Okay, 12 volt, 4000 amp. And I was told by a number of people, mechanics, other YouTube people, told me that Noco, I don't know how true it is, but the UL listing that's on the actual purchase container forced Noco to change it from 4,000 to 3,000. I don't know if there was misadvertising going on or what, but that's why it now says 3,000, because I also know that the Noco, this one here, and the old Noco is exactly the same. Even the price was exactly the same. The only thing I saw changed was this number from 4,000 to 3,000. Now, I don't know if that's a fact, so don't kill me in the comment section. This is what I heard by a number of mechanics and a lot of YouTube videos out there. They tell you that. So you can look up on YouTube. There's a lot of people who say that a Noco was forced to change this from 4,000 to 3,000. Because why else, you know, why else would they change from 4,000 to 3,000? That doesn't make any sense. Because there's plenty of 4,000 models out there. And also, it doesn't really make sense to me why they would make them change it from 4,000 to 3,000. Like, even if it was, how many units out there claim to be like 6,000 amps, 4,000 amps, and they're like half of that? So they should be forced to change if that was the case. So I don't really, you know why. So if anybody knows, let me know, because that's kind of important to me. I want to know why they changed from 4,000 to 3,000. I mean, some people just said that the 4,000 was too much power, so they lowered it to 3,000. That doesn't make sense to me, okay? But yes, guys, we're gonna turn the unit on right up here. You turn it on, and you see the lights up here, and you also, this is the boost button right down here, the exclamation point, and you have a built-in voltmeter. So when your cables, when your clamps and cables are hooked up to a battery, this will show the voltage. This will show the voltage, and if the battery is too low, it may not show the voltage. But we're gonna go in the garage in a little while, and we're gonna test this on just the battery, a dead battery, okay? So yeah, and also, if your unit, when you hook up to a battery and your unit is chasing, if these lights are chasing, that means that the Noco accepts that there's a battery there, knows there's battery because there's enough voltage, therefore you do not have to hit the boost button, okay? However, if these lights are just like that, it means you have to push the boost. Where is it? Push the boost button, hold it for 2 to 3 seconds. Now you'll see it's letting out, what is that? 11.7 watts, and it's blinking the white, that's how you know there's live power in here. Now, this is very important, guys. Being there's live power in here, do not, I repeat, do not mess around with these cables. Do not touch them together since the boost button is pushed in. All the security features are now bypassed. So live power is in this. So when the boost button is pushed, all bets are off and this is live power. Now when you push the button and shut it off, now there's just, there's security features on there. This has no spark protection and reverse polarity protection. Okay, so now, since the boost button is not pushed, if you go to touch these together, nothing should happen. They're touched together, and when you notice, there's a red light letting you know, see the red light? It's letting you know that the cables are touching, or the clamps are touching. See how it changed? Immediately. See? Yeah, these clamps are massive. I actually, these clamps are so massive. Hang on a sec. Yeah, I only see the wire on the
the bottom. I don't see it on the top and the bottom. But these cables are so massive that if you have a hard to reach battery, this may not fit since the head is so huge. I'd much rather it be the like shark bite cables, you know, the ones with the little like triangular. I'll show you in the garage, but yeah, these are so, they're massive. They're great quality, don't get me wrong, but if you have a hard to reach battery, it may be hard to get to the battery, just to let you know. But this unit used to sell for about $349. I got it for a little over $200 last year on sale, but now I think they're about $299, if I'm not mistaken. The operating temperature is negative 20 Celsius to 50 Celsius, it's saying on here. Charging temp is 0 Celsius to 40 Celsius. The storage temp is negative 20 Celsius to 50 Celsius. Okay. What else we got on here? This is the GB150, like I said before. And like I said, you have, if you were to charge the unit with the USB port, hang on a sec, there should be another cable in here somewhere. Bear with me. Oh, here it is, yep. Here's the other cable. Sorry guys, I almost missed it. Here it is. You have the USB micro, which I do not like. I wish it was a USB-C. To the USB-A, okay? Now, bear with me. Okay, if you were to use the USB micro here, see how the wire's in there? And now you're gonna charge this, plug it into a computer or a USB-A port. This is gonna take about 11 to 13 hours, okay? Which, I mean, if you wanna do it all night, if you're like going to bed, you put it in, maybe if you want 11, 12 hours, 13 hours and you have time, to use that, but I recommend, like I said before, to use the car charger. That'll take a quarter of the time, like I said before. But yeah, it comes with the USB micro, the USB-A. I almost forgot about that one. Now, this unit is also, see how the rubber flaps cover the ports. So this is IP65 rated. And the wires on the Noco GB150 are much longer than your conventional jump starters. And if you look, this is what I like. The light is on. You could actually hook this up to a battery and you could see what you're doing at the same time, you see? If it was on, if these cables were down here, you know, and the light was over here, it would be hard to, you know, but yeah. This is really neat. Really, they did a good job on this. But like I said, I did a review on this a long time ago, and unfortunately, I did not do the wire. I never showed you the wiring. Unfortunately, that was my fault. Noco Boost GB150 with 3,000 amps. Let's shut her off. Now, just gonna go over a little thing. This is 12 volt, like I said, with the built-in voltmeter. This will jump start up to 9 liter gasoline and 7 liter diesel engines, okay? This will jump start 80 times on a single charge. That's 80 on a single charge. That's amazing. 500 lumen flashlight with 6 total settings, I believe. You have an 88 watt hour battery here, lithium ion battery. 24,000 milliamp hour, that's to charge your cell phone, laptops, iPads, sporting equipment, camping equipment, whatever. Okay, this is bark proof and reverse polarity protection. Okay, except when the boost button is pushed, there is no protection. When the boost button is pushed, there is no protection, so do not mess around with this. Make sure you're doing things correctly, or you may hurt yourself. Okay, the height on this is 7.28 inches, and the width is 12.40 inches, and the depth is 2.72 inches. Up here, 2.72 inches, okay. And you have a 1-year hassle-free warranty on this. And like I said, it comes with the female and the male cigarette adapter. That's the quickest way to charge your unit. Now we're gonna go in the garage and we're gonna check out and see how it's gonna jumpstart a dead battery. All right, we're not gonna do this on an actual car, we're just gonna do it on a dead battery. We're gonna show you the battery has no power,
Now we're going to show you when we hit the boost button that it's putting power in the battery. So just imagine this in a vehicle. You've seen me jumpstart vehicles a million times. Check my other videos out if you want to see that. Okay, we're going to go inside, check it out. Hey guys, we're back in the garage now, and as you can see, I have a dead battery here, partially dead. You have the Noco GB150 here with 3000 amps, and we have our clamps here. And if you notice, we have our little alligator clamps hooked into these because, as you could see, we only have side posts on here. We only have side posts, we don't have top posts, so we can't hook up a clamp here because there's nothing to hook it up to. So we're gonna need to attach the negative. Now watch what happens when we hit the negative on here. Wait, hook it again. 10.2 volts is in the multimeter right now. 10.2 volts is in the Noco right now, as you can see. Now, when we turn it on, watch what happens. Turn to 11.5 volts. So that should be enough. You can hear it clicking. Hear it? Hear the module? And yeah, this is basically the only way to hook up the battery with these little alligator clamp wires because there's no top posts, unfortunately. Yeah. And now watch when we hit the power. Watch, it's gonna go down. See that? Pretty cool. Yeah, because you guys have seen me jumpstart a car a million times. Just imagine this battery is in the car. Okay, imagine this dead battery, well, partially dead battery, is in the car outside. And you can see how much power was in there, you know, the 10.4. Then you turn it on. And you see it jump to 11.5. Now, if you want, let's hit the boost button just to see. I don't think anything. See it? Right? The boost even, I don't think the boost even worked just because it was already chasing. Yeah. I think when the lights are chasing, it's hard to... Yeah, no. The boost button's not working, really. I mean, it's not going to, like, boost it up anymore anyway, you know? The boost button only disables the security features and gives live power in the cables at all times. That's all it does. People have the misconception that when you push the boost button, it's going to let out, you know, so much more power, this and that. Technically, it just disables the security features. That's all the boost button does. So let's see the reverse polarity on here. Since we're talking, let's put the positive or the negative on the positive. See what happens. Hopefully nothing. And reverse polarity. And if you ever see that red light up there blinking, it means your unit is too hot or too cold. Okay, just so you're aware. So if you see a steady red light, here, that means reverse polarity is detected. Straighten out your cables and wires. Okay, if you see this red light blinking on and off, that means your unit is too hot or too cold. So what you're gonna have to do is shut it off or warm it up or do something, but all right. So yeah, guys. And like I said, we are shooting on our new DJI Osmo Pocket 3 camera. Let me know how you like it, guys. Hey guys, shake your neighbor's hand, please, because the fighting in this world, it has to stop. As we all know, there's no need for the fighting. We don't need it. All right, let's start getting along. All right, why can't we? All right, and again, subscribe to our channel. It helps the algorithm. Smash the thumbs up button, guys. If you like these videos, smash that thumbs up button. It goes a long way. Okay, we're gonna have a live stream in the next couple days, as I posted a couple days ago, but you must be a subscriber. We're gonna give away some jump starters, some gift cards, and some other stuff probably. All right, so yeah. Click that bell icon, click all, so you never miss an upcoming video or post of ours. And guys, I'm Michael. Peace out. Love yous.